Got the little mini excavator and the mulcher and some buckets. So returning to a previous job. This is the one I put the overflow in year or so ago through the driveway that had all the utilities in it. And I'm back to do a little mulching around the back of the house over here. So let me get this unloaded and I'll show you what the plan is. So today's plan is to kind of get this backyard a little bit more under control, get in here and kind of mulch down all the little undergrowth that I can. He's going to redo the sheds back there, get all that small stuff mulch down on each side, all the brush by the bigger trees here, just run in here and get all that mulch down. That way they can keep everything mowed a little closer to the trees here. And then I'm going to come in. I was supposed to tear that little shed down there and pile it up, but he didn't get everything cleaned out of it, so I'll have to hold off on that. But I'm going to come in here and just mulch everything down along the wood line, get all that opened up so that all those bushes and everything will kind of quit encroaching on the open path here. So these jobs are a little difficult just due to the sheer amount of crap that is laying around. You got a pile of blocks, shingles, ladders, bricks, pots, all sorts of junk over there. A metal ring from around a barrel, whole stack of metal right there. Cinder blocks I've already pushed out of the way and picked up. You just got to come over here and pick stuff up and put it over there where you're not going to mulch. I'm going to hit some of that, but I mean, I can't sit here and move everything out of the way for them. I'll get what I can, get it opened up, and hopefully I can clean this crap up. But it is making this look a lot nice and wider. Well, it's not the greatest in the world because there's so much trash and bricks and blocks and everything, but definitely got this opened up a lot and exposed. We're going to clean out the shed there and tear it down. And that's a lot wider. I'm going to take the mulcher up here and go up to the edge of the pond and cut some of that back now. So I got some of those river birch trees down by the pond. You can tell they are very difficult to mulch up. They like to get wrapped around the drum there. But I want to extend the shoulder of the driveway out right here. So I'm going to go from here all the way down there to the house and mulch all that back and make it nice and wide. Thank you. makes the driveway look twice as wide, getting all that brush and everything mulched back. So that's done. Now he's got a couple trails back here in the back that has a few random trees that need to be mulched down along the trail. So I'm gonna go grab lunch, come back and get started on that. Thank you. Okay, so I finished up around the house and came down here to a trail in the woods, and a customer wants me to go around here and mulch down any of the trees that are hanging over, which make it difficult to drive a truck around here. Got a few stumps right here I'm either going to try to mulch down and or dig up with a bucket, but it's probably a half a mile around here. Just going to go around here and any tree that I've got orange paint on, see if I can't take it down. Alright, so I have made it all the way around the trail with the mulcher and cut everything that I could. These hardwood trees right here, they're like 4 to 5 inches, are too much for that thing to sit there and try to mulch. It just jams it up and makes me very angry. So I'm going to come in here with the bucket and just rip them down. He told me just to pile them up here. They will cut them up and use them for firewood if they ever camp down here. So I got the 18-inch bucket on, and I'm going to go ahead and start taking a couple of these down, just make it a little wider in a few spots. And that is balloon number 2 for today. So definitely a clearing job, finding balloons. Thank you. that's a wrap. I went around there, there's probably about 30 trees that I had to take down, and now the trail is wide enough to be able to drive a pickup truck all the way around through here and tie back into the field right there. So it's been a 10 and a half hour day, so time to load this up, head home.